I'm Ravina from 3A Group 3rd year. Today I'm going to discuss about my topic environmental hygiene in a form of slideshow. Let's get started.
Aizirik Topchu Baibna ma'am. Environmental hygiene. It is a branch of public health that is concerned with the control of all those factors in men's surrounding or physical environment which may have deleterious effect on human health and well-being. Two aspects are there, hygiene at household level or hygiene at community level. Now we'll see the state of world. Every 20 seconds, a child dies as a result of poor sanitation. That's very sad. About 790 million people, means 11% of world's population, without access to an improved water supply. 850,000 people die every year from lack of access to good water and sanitation. Hygiene. Now we'll discuss about the importance of environmental hygiene. Unsafe water hygiene, excreta disposal, urban air pollution, indoor smoke from household use of solid fuels, leading cause of death in low and middle income countries. Linked environmental factors are 3rd, lower respiratory illness, 6th, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, 7th, diarrheal
infections.
Now
we'll discuss about maintenance of environmental hygiene. Let's pull it out. Hand hygiene, such as washing your hands, cover your nose and mouth when coughing or sneezing, having good personal hygiene, using proper food preparations and storing food. Protective barriers include gloves, gown, mask, eye protection or face shield.
Now we'll see the components of environmental hygiene. Let's pull it out. Personal hygiene, water supply, human waste disposal, solid waste management, vector control, food hygiene, healthful hygiene, occupational hygiene. It describes the area of environmental health and hygiene that will be of importance to you as a health worker. Now benefits of environmental hygiene. Let's pull it out this also. Protect us from diseases, infections, waterborne diseases and pollution. Give us an opportunity to recycle all those waste materials which could be so health-safe waste of energy. It helps us to keep our world clean and improves our health and living habits. As the girl is saying, as I'm cleaning, you should also clean. I'll end this explanation by saying a slogan, clean it today for a better tomorrow. Thank you.
These are the content of my presentation. Definition we have discussed earlier. State of the world. 1.2 billion people do not have access to safe drinking water. 3 billion people do not have access to proper sanitation. Perhaps 50% of all solid waste is uncollected. No one knows how many people are flooded out each year. And 3 billion people have to survive on less than $2 per day. Objectives of environmental hygiene are prevention and control of biological, chemical, physical, sociological, psychological hazards. Hygiene and the environment. Environmental hygiene is a vital part of good infection prevention and control. Good health is not merely the absence of disease, it is also a reflection of the social and mental well-being of a people in a community. These are important terminology: cleaning, disinfection, disinfectant, and detergent. Components of hygiene and environmental health. Personal hygiene, water supply, human waste disposal, solid waste management, vector control, food hygiene, healthful housing, institutional hygiene, water pollution, occupational hygiene. Concepts and principles in hygiene and environmental health. First, environmental health and disease transmission. Second, the place of environmental health in your community. Third, environmental intervention models. Fourth, environmental risk factors. Now we'll discuss about COVID-19 and air pollution. Researchers found that air pollution has intensified the pandemic, but the lockdown and related measures implemented by countries to stop the spread of COVID-19 have also led to a decrease in economic activities and drop in road transport, temporarily cleaning skies, and decreasing levels of certain air pollutants. You can have a look at the transmission of COVID-19. Now, origin of COVID-19 and prevention. Origin of the outbreak and its transmission pathway are yet to be asserted. We know diseases passed from animals to humans, means zoonotic diseases, are on the rise. As the world continues to see unprecedented destruction of wild habitat by human activity. Nature is sending us a message with the coronavirus pandemic and the ongoing climate crisis. To prevent the next pandemic, we must transform our relationship with nature.
Stay safe, stay home. Clean it today for a better tomorrow. Now these are the reference of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.